good. Well, last time I saw you was in Montreal at the Miller Fest, and you just got off the plane and your gear got stolen, and it was like middle of the night type of thing. God, what's been going on with you?
Well, I've cleaned up my act.
Yeah, I've heard
quite
that.
A bit. Mm-hmm. Quite a bit. No more drinking, no more drugs, you know? Some people may be able to do one or the other. I won't get into that, you know? Some people may be able to drink right, you know? But I can't do that. I've went too far with it. And I started, instead of just partying, or instead of just drinking to have a drink, I had to go off and be obsessive with it. And it just doesn't work for me. I wish a lot of people that can't handle it would realize that they couldn't, and it'll happen in time, you know. But it's something that's a lot harder to deal with than a lot of people realize, you know. And it took me a long time to realize that I knew I couldn't stop, but I have to do something about that and stop, you know.
Well, what made you realize suddenly that you got to take control of this?
Well, I fell apart.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I fell apart.
Like, couldn't play?
Well, like I said, I was still playing gigs, but I was physically and emotionally and spiritually just bankrupt.
It's really difficult to control that kind of habit. What kind of support system do you have around you?
I went through treatment in Atlanta, Georgia. And I've got a step program, 12-step program that I live by now. And all the people in that program are my support. Plus, I have the bass player, Tommy Shannon. He's also in the program. So is my drum tech and guitar tech. And we help each other out.
A lot of people associate drug and alcohol abuse with show business. Do you think it really is an occupational hazard?
It's a myth.
Yeah?
But that myth is overwhelming, you know. A lot of it has to do with stress. A lot of it has to do with a schedule that just keeps a person work is, and show business is your life, and it's a lie, you know. We have a life and we play music. That's the way it was when we started off.
To break here in Canada. I remember one of your aspirations was to one day go back to Austin and help some of the young musicians there, maybe start a record label. Have you done any of that?
It'd be nice. There's also other people around that, you know, that we've heard through the years that we would really like to help, because they really care about what they're doing, you know. When somebody really cares about the music they play, then first off, they're going to play it better because it means something to them. And it comes through in the music, and other people see that. And I just happen to be one of those other people, and I like to try to help if I can.
I know you've always said that you're a student of the guitar, that you'll probably never master it. But I mean, when people watch you play, I don't think we'd ever notice any subtle differences in anything that would say that you're getting better.
All I know all about is what I figured out, and that's probably jumbled up too. Yeah, I just do the best I can at listening and remembering what I learn of all the things that I hear in every other guitar player that ever excites me, you know, because there's going to be something in everybody that I like. And if I don't, I probably didn't listen good, you know. So I just keep trying.
Can you actually feel, like, can you say from one week to the next, yeah, I'm getting better at this particular thing?
Well, it's more like a roller coaster.
Oh, yeah? Know?
Sometimes you get in a rut, and then all of a sudden the rut will break, you know, and things start feeling better. Playing wise, you know, and that usually runs kind of along with just human experience as well, you know. Life in general seems like a rut, and usually it's because my foot's stuck in the mud, you know, and I need to get up and do something.
Something Stevie Ray's done lately is appear in a new movie, Back to the Beach, with Musketeer Annette Funicello and her pal Frankie Avalon, who volunteered some insight into why Stevie Ray was invited.
Dick Dale who was the king of the surf guitar.
Excuse me.
Who is the king of the surf guitar is in it. And Stevie Ray Vaughan, who was the happening guitar of the 80s, is in it. And together we put them together because the music is so similar now between the 60s and the 80s. Somewhat sounds are different, technology is different. So we put them together, and I think it's a good combination.
Basically, it's a cameo. You know, I play myself playing me in a bar scene.
What's the bar?
It's Daddy O's. And we play Pipeline, Dick Dale and the Deltones, and with me sitting in with him is basically what it is.
Doing his tune, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a song that I've done all my life, you know, Pipeline. And it's just a fun tune to play. So I was invited to do it on the movie and said, sure.